Next, now look at some of the circuits which are standard in our computer system, which are very essential to compute the arithmetic and logical functions. Okay, so we will start with a very simple function, which is half adder. Half adder is a logical circuit that adds two binary bits. That is, the input is 2 bits, so number of inputs is 2, and we have denoted the input using x and y. When we add 2 bits, okay, how many outputs we will get? When we add, what is the result? Result is a sum, and we get a sum. Sometimes when we add, okay, say for example, when I add 0 with 0, the sum is 0. When we add 0 with 1, the sum is 1. When we add 1 with 0, the sum is 1. When we add 1 with 1, okay, we get 2 in decimal, right? 1 plus 1 is 2 in decimal, and decimal 2 is represented in binary as 10. So when we get 10, the sum is going to be 0, and this 1 is going to appear as carry. So the number of outputs is also 2 for a half adder. When we try to add 2 binary bits, the number of inputs is 2 and the number of outputs is also 2, and the outputs are sum and carry, and the carry is 0 for all these input combination except the last one, which is 1 1. The carry will be 1 for 1 1, and sum will be 0 here. And we can get the expression for this one using the 2 variable Carnot map. There is only 1 1 here, so carry will be xy, that is what is given here. Here there are 2 ones, and see here, this is 1 and this is 2, which will be appearing in the diagonal positions of the 2 variable Carnot map, so we cannot club them together. So they will be appearing as independent blocks in the Carnot map. So the simplified expression for S will be, we have x to be 0 here, so it is x bar y or x y bar. Okay, x bar y or x y bar. So this is the expression for half adder. Now we can realize this circuit using gates. Carry is xy, so we can use an AND gate, okay, and supply x and y and produce C. And for realizing this, we can compute this term using one AND gate and compute this term using another AND gate and supply the result of AND gates to an OR gate to get the sum. But the preferred way of doing this is using the XOR gate, because this is XOR of X and Y. So we can supply X and Y to an XOR gate and produce sum, and get the inputs X and Y, supply to an AND gate and produce C. So this is a half adder circuit.